have a designated team for every OR, and there is a lot of pre-work that goes into being prepared in that room. And so it's a delicate dance, and it's very interesting to watch because it's almost like there's a lot of busy bees and everybody has their individual tasks and they know their tasks and they know their roles within that team. Once, you know, we get the patient in and get them off to sleep, get them positioned and drape, get ready, all that, and we have a timeout. It's a really crucial part of any procedure. At that moment, everybody stops what they're doing, everybody's focus is on the patient, and we run through exactly who this patient is, what procedure they're having, any sort of allergies they have, and it's that last and final check to say, okay, this is the surgery that we're doing. Are we all on the same page as the team? Yes, okay, let's go.
It is definitely not a one-man field. I mean, it is actually such a ridiculous notion to think of the surgeon kind of being the end-all be-all, because without an anesthesiologist, the patient's not even asleep, so can't do surgery. Without a circulator or a scrub tech to have the instruments available, you're never going to get the instruments you need. Can't do the surgery.
Delivering surgical care is a team sport, and you are a small piece of the puzzle, whether it's directly related to healthcare delivery or even, you know, the larger system as a whole. It allows this type of care to be delivered in the first place. Same goes for the physical therapists and the rehab and the secretaries. I mean, it's literally just continues to build out of this massive village.
I would never know the pathology if I didn't have a scan, so we need radiologies, x-ray techs, you need nurses. This often comes up amongst me and my co-residents. We make jokes that if we get called on an airplane, I mean, we'll know basic medical pathology, but ultimately as a brain surgeon, like, what are we gonna do?
That's why it's crucial that whatever role that you're in, you understand your role.
You be the best at what you do, let everybody else be great at what they do.
You just rely on so many people. And once again, when the usual person is gone, you just realize how collaborative this truly is.
I think as a junior resident, you're the person with the least knowledge in your team taking care of a patient. The ICU nurses know more than you, the senior residents know more than you, the patient care techs who work with these patients and day in and day out know more than you about taking care of these individual people in the neuro ICU. And you develop that knowledge and you build those skills very quickly. I think respect for every member of the team is the real key.
The scrub techs that help with the cases that interns and PGY2s are usually on are like the sharpest, just because they know, like, they're part of your training.
Like, you can't do your job without another one of our coworkers doing theirs, right? Like, so the role of the circulator nurse affects the role of the surgical tech, which affects the role of the resident and the, you know, the attending and so on and so forth.
Here at Barrow, you get put in a case and you have the opportunity to get as far as you can, and then you get to that area where you're at that part where you either get those butterflies in your stomach, you know you're kind of at the edge of your comfort zone, you call for help. And then whenever the attending or the senior resident, someone more senior to you, comes in, you really watch closely at what were the first 2-3 moves they made to get past that one part you were stuck on.
The journey to becoming a neurosurgeon, it's a grind, it's a long grind. You're not constantly moving from one position to the other. It's a 7-year residency. And people don't realize this getting into it, but you're gonna need support. And that's gonna be from family, that's gonna be from your co-residents, that's gonna be from mentorship. And knowing how to take advantage of those resources, knowing how to tap into it, and how to refuel, kind of re-energize through those mentorships, through family, is critical, because it's not all gonna be smooth sailing.
we all stay quite connected. And so it really is a group effort. And everyone kind of has, I think it's a bond also formed just by going through the same experiences that we all went through junior call, and everyone went through that feeling of feeling absolutely terrified when you got three sick patients and you don't know what to do and which one to help and how to help them so that everyone's okay. And when you're doing things like that, you grow together.
But that's what Barrow thrives on, I think, is that we instill a sense of autonomy in all of our residents, but at the same time, we always reassure them that there is no shame in calling for help.
We are friends. We're all in the same situation that sucks sometimes, that's freaking awesome other times. That we get to do it together.
The phrase "it takes a village" has really rang true to me, and I think it also takes a village to make a neurosurgeon as well. You need that support both at home so that you can be at work, working those long hours, learning about those cases, and then also here, you need the support to build up that surgical confidence that we were talking about.
You know, we're in this as a team with a bunch of residents. They've all been in those situations too. So, you know, talking through situations with your residents, hey, you know, this happened, or, you know, I messed up, I did this. And 9 times out of 10, your co-resident's like, oh yeah, I've done the same thing.
There is no way to come out of this sort of pressure, high stress situation, than to be close to the people you work with in these close quarters. So we are each other's support system.
As you progress and you kind of are senior to more and more individuals on the team, not forgetting what it was like to be in that role before, understanding where that person is at, whether they're a month into residency, whether they're 3 years into residency, is incredibly important, because it's easy to rag on someone if they make a mistake that you think is a really dumb error. And it's easy to forget that you were a first year resident once. And balancing that with, at the same time, keeping incredibly high expectations of individuals. And because this is a high stakes situation, you know, if a mistake is made, that could cost someone their life.
It's all well and good to talk about traits that make for successful or master surgeons, but none of that really matters if you don't have this supportive safety net, this supportive cocoon that helps you achieve the things you're going for, that supports you through your journey. And I think for me, it's my family, it's my wife, it's my children. It's just knowing that I have my home established and in good hands when I'm here working so hard.
Yeah, like I get the best of both worlds. It's unfair, but I get to get home and get recharged by three little kids messing around. This is propping me up unbelievably, right? I go home, recharge way faster than probably any of my colleagues, just because I got innocent kids at home. Not innocent, but. And then I get to kind of leave, get back into the compartmentalized, single-minded, I want to get better at neurosurgery.
My spouse picks up all the slack, and without that, just don't have the time to actually be committed to be here and at home to be thinking about work still. Having someone who takes care of your basic necessities is a huge advantage, and I think absolutely made me a better trainee.
There is an incredible wealth of knowledge just carried in everyone around us.
Everybody has a role. Everybody has a common goal to make sure patient safety is achieved, improve patient outcomes, and be efficient in everything that you do. We have a lot of seasoned nurses, seasoned scrub techs in the OR that also teaches the residents, especially the new ones.
My attendings in my medical school used to always say, real medicine happens in the hallways. You know, often the majority of our learning comes from talking to one another and learning from the lessons that each of us have gained. And Dr. Ponce says that good surgeons learn from their own mistakes and great surgeons learn from other mistakes, so that collectively our knowledge grows as well.
There is a lot of work that goes into the team in the OR. There's a lot of moving pieces. There's a lot of people a part of that puzzle, but it's understanding your role both individually and from a team perspective in order to be set up for success and care for the patient.
A lot of this almost feels like magic, and not having the necessary people, the necessary tools, the necessary services at your disposal exposes the magic for what it really is. And that kind of shows you that this takes a very large, dedicated team.
And so with the patient at the center of this whole ecosystem comes how that team kind of takes form with the surgeon, with the hospitalist, with the anesthesiologist, with the nurses, with the residents. And we're all kind of working in sync. It's like a choreographed machine working toward the end of delivering excellent patient care.